Interesting. A few small fires provide a sense of calm for the caravan. Though the villagers keep well away from the ravens, there's enough light to see you are no longer in a man-made mine, but a natural cave of sorts. What are we doing down here? Staying alive and keeping Bellower from the dredge. I thought that was obvious. But we keep heading down like we're hunting dwarves. The Valka gives you a ghost of a smile. Until today, no one but a few on the council knew about these tunnels, not even Menders. We didn't create them, but we have used them a great deal over the years to travel far distances quickly. Zephyr becomes quiet, awaiting a question. Why keep them a secret? Because the more you know of this world, the more frightening it can be. If children knew how many spiders were in their house, they'd never sleep. And it never hurts to have a way to outmaneuver your enemies. The Valka does not respond. Zephyr becomes quiet, awaiting a question. Where do they lead? Practically everywhere. Arborang, Vo, Grafheim, or what's left of it. I'm not sure anyone knows the full extent of these underground paths, but we're about to enter a corridor, one of the main tunnels. Zephyr becomes quiet, awaiting a question. So where are we headed? Where would you go, knowing you possess the sleeping body of the immortal Sunder General? You want us to drag him to bloody Manahar, don't you? Manahar is the safest place to secure Bellower's body. Whatever drew the dredge army towards us in Vindal, the council can find a way to stop it. And what about my ravens? So far, helping Valka pays less than a bloodshed coin. And that is why I am talking to you alone now. The corridor will lead us to Manahar in a week's time. See us there safely, and I give you a genuine Valka oath. You will be rewarded well enough to never need to work again. You look around at the cave walls and back the way you came. We'll go to Manahar. We were heading there after the Blue River anyway. At least I have 14 days of supplies, so I can rest, get everyone back to full strength, and not, hopefully not have, I wonder if I can train up a bunch of clansmen, turn them into fighters, and see if that'll maybe help lower the battle difficulty. I'm not really sure about that mechanic. Alright, let's see if we have any, I was hoping to get some free renown. So let's see, we could train up some clansmen. We would count as days of rest. Let's do it, see how it works. Let's get 100 of them. 2 days, the quartermaster says, that's how long it'll take. If they're not comfortable with the blade by then, I'll eat my beard, he spits. Speaking of eating, we have enough food for 2 days of training? Fine on food, train them. And send them in, Hulpy says with an evil grin. Yeah, so we're gonna get less supplies from the clansmen. And the fighters are there to protect them. But I think the days that we spent training should have also counted as days of rest as well. And I was gonna spend at least two days anyway. So now we'll see how that goes. Should probably rest more. You know what? We'll do 100 more just so we have more fighters than clansmen, and then we'll call it there. Okay. We might have to take Nichols or someone else along too because we lost the captain. What's going on here? You hear Folko ask a group of ravens. They're standing around whimpering, a whimpering man on his knees. He kept whining about being hungry, one of your fighters says. We found these little growing berries for him. But suddenly he's not so hungry, the others chuckle. Let's let Folka hand it. Make your fighters eat them. As the fighters chew, their mouths glow with berry juice. Folka and the man she helped start laughing. The fighters look at each other and laugh. After a while, they show no signs of illness. They don't taste half bad either, says one raven. Others start collecting the berries to eat and squeeze, waving glowing hands in the dark. Mothers rub their smiling children in the juices in order to keep track of them. Hello? The man's sudden appearance makes you tense. I didn't mean to sneak up on you. It's something I do. I mean, something I've learned to do. Something that will get you killed if you do it to me again. Okay, yes, understood. But it does have its uses. Just allow me to fight alongside you in a fight. You won't regret it. You scoff and turn away from the man. We need your help. We definitely need your help. Ditch is walking alongside a woman you've never seen before. He seems captivated by her, but her unfamiliarity nags at you. You turn towards the couple, but it appears Ditch has just said something to offend her. She slaps his face and takes off through the caravan. You'll keep an eye out for her. Though torches highlight the craggy black rocks and puddles on the path underfoot, they do little to keep everyone together. Sharp turns around boulders quickly block lines of sight. We've lost a few families, Zephyr informs you. We need to stop and find them. You consider your options. Keep moving, shout and attract something else. Tell her to find them, or this is the only time. Shouting won't help. No, we need to keep moving. You agreed to help us reach Manahar safely, Zephyr says, but you shake your head. Just the cart. These people are your responsibility. Her disgust is visible, but she says no more. Water barrels are running low. Halfie, your quartermaster, reports. And I'll be damned if I start licking these slimy rocks for a drink. The shield maiden looks at you. If these people start getting desperate for water down here, you cut her off. I know. Send out some scouts, we'll camp here until they return. Some of your ravens and other members of the caravan group up and grab torches before heading off in a different direction. Better catch some rest while you can, Fulka says. Nothing to do until they get back, anyway. Laying down, you focus on the sounds of a small drip somewhere in the cave. It grows louder, like the beat of a drum, like thousands of feet marching behind you. You turn and everyone stops. You see the glowing eyes of your army looking at you in admiration. 100 members break formation to dig holes in the cavern floors and place stone bowls in the depressions. The bowls quickly fill with water, and the first is offered to you. You slake your thirst before seeing your red armored reflection in the bowl. You wake up with a shout when Fulka joins you. What was it this time? She asks. Instruct her on finding water. Dig holes, you say. Put bowls down in them. See if they fill with water. She sets some ravens to follow your strange commands, and shortly you hear the whooping cheers of success. The celebration brings all the scouts back early. Extra renown, more supplies. A rope bridge with wooden planking crosses an open span in the caravan's formation. Looks old, Fulka says. Narrow, not meant for carts. Get the menders to reinforce it. Cross it one cart at a time. Both Zephyr and Nichols move through the crowd and begin tracing patterns in the air with their staffs. The only thing you see is a slight lift in the bridge, but they walk across first to calm any fears. The caravan crosses without any incidents. So, I want to see if that healed, or that counted as a day's rest for Bulvark or not. No, still 2 days. And what do we have here? The young man stands tall and proud as you approach. Bulwark, I was thinking, well, wondering, about what it takes to become a raven. Never heard stories about a test or trial to join you. Is there a test? Why do you care? Aren't you Zephyr's lackey? Well, apprentice, yes. I'm a full mender training to become a Valkyr. Part of our training requires world experience. Couldn't you work with a blacksmith or something? Nichols frowns at her. Would you kill someone for coin? Kill for... The mender's face pales a bit. I mean, I guess, if that was a job. Fulka wops up and clamps a hand on one of Nichols' now sagging shoulders. Most of what we do never makes it into the Skald songs. I guess I need to think on this a bit more. Let us know in Manahar. Nicholas nods as you walk off. The spearman is standing alone, staring off into the depths of the caves. If you take off down one of these tunnels, we're not going after you. Back doesn't respond. He doesn't want to talk. I like him already. Do you know the worst part about it all? Never mind. I don't like him. Foku gives you a look before turning to Back. Tell me the best part of it all first. The best part? It may all be over, sooner than we think. You squint, not liking his words. That's not really what I meant, but go ahead. What's the worst part of everything? It's the silence. You give Foku a look. He hasn't slept near Ali. That man makes all kinds of strange sounds. That's just noise. There's a silence from the loneliness. Foku inhales sharply. He's hit a sore spot. Maybe these tunnels and caves make it worse. There used to be days of talk. We used to laugh. Are you talking about your fond spear again? Back turns and stares at you with the eyes of a man undecided and ongoing mad. Love helps where she can, but no. There was another. Now there's an endless hole shaped like her. And if I don't keep filling it with work or drink, he walks away without finishing his thought. Keep an eye on him. I'm the only one who gets to lose their mind and start killing. He's not crazy. He's alone. Whoever she was, he still thinks she was the greatest. I'm jealous of her. It would be nice to have someone feel that way about me. You shake your head, snort, and walk away. Humans. Okay, so... as soon as morale goes down a bit, we'll rest so that we can keep it high. Actually, now that that other man, or what's his name, the assassin joined us, we could probably get some extra renown from that. Oh yeah, I did. Did I already use 4? Or did I just use 2? Thank you. 18 renown for free is pretty awesome.
Slept in caves like this for entire winters. But there's something about this place. Something old, unfamiliar. I don't like it. But I don't like all these humans on the verge of panic either. Maybe these dwellings up ahead will calm them down.
Zephyr looks up at the giant shaped formation, glittering with strange glowing patterns. The Valka know almost nothing about this ancient race's culture, let alone their god, Vaznan. The name alone might be wrong, but we have a framework of letters based on repeated patterns found here. She wanders around the glowing pools of the Godstone. If you're correct, Vaznan was not their only god, but he became one of the most powerful at the cost of everything dear to him. She looks at you. Of course, if what you hold dear is something like control, maybe there is power in letting go. Gems of various size and shape are found embedded in the surrounding stones. Clansmen are soon hammering away in an attempt to pry a particularly large gem loose. The ringing of hammers echoes through the deep. Say nothing and watch them work. Clansmen go about their work. You never knew that these men had the skills they did. Two leverage the ends of a large pick, while two men in the front guide the tips. These men are miners. It takes only minutes for them to skillfully pry the gem from its deep socket. Talented workers who should be learned from, not dominated. A man from behind clasps you on the back, smiling. The miners walk forward and place the red gem in your hands with a grateful smile. Let's take a look at that. So the gem of Vaznan. Plus 3 strength talents, 20% to crit, 2 strength, minus 4 will. Don't mind if I do. Let's see here. I need 3 kills. I may actually do a training mission, just a training fight, because everyone needs like 1 or 2 kills to level up. And I could definitely use better troops. Also, with these pools right now, there's 3 options. One of them gives everyone, I think it's like 3 kills worth of experience. The other one gives you supplies, and then the last one actually just injures you. So I think I'm just gonna take the supplies for that one, because you can always train for free to get that same renown. This was a sacred sanctuary for those who built it, the Valka says, walking around the perfectly round rippling pools, at least from what we've uncovered. The top pool was for reflecting on one's deeds, the middle to ask for strength from the world, and the bottom pool was for insight into one's future. She hesitates before saying, I've never done anything but study their inscriptions. So, reflect on your past, is supplies, ask for strength, is kills, And looking ahead, it just injures you. So we're not going to do that. We never left the pools alone, but I'm sure that that does nothing, so. The quiet drips and the soft glows in the cave lend themselves to a natural reverence. You drop to a knee by the top pool, expecting to drink from it, when you see your reflection in the surface. Your horns are back. You must be in your first century, not fully grown. You feel the cool wind from Irenx's wings above you, and glance up to see Rodimir slipping away from one cloud to the next, heading towards the mountains ahead of you. The few Varl around you laugh at your wonder, calling you a dreamer. You smile. When you open your eyes, you are back in the cave. Your cupped hand is still poised over the pool, but the water has gone dark. The other pools are all the same. You were gone a while, Fulka says. Almost missed the last from your fighters. She tosses a bag to you. You found some food, probably tucked away by the Valka. Alright, so let's head out. Scout rushes back to the caravan. There's gold down here. You feel the surge of excitement like everyone else. A vein as thick as my leg just over, well, just around. The man looks left and right, confused. Damn it, I'm all turned around. So. A lot of your fighters can desert you here, I think, if you choose some of the different options. You grab the man by his tunic and lift him against the low cave ceiling. Start remembering or I'll stick you up here permanently. The man's eyes are wide. I remember, he says. Follow me. A few hours pass while following the scout. Some with you take wrong turns and go missing, and one man falls into a ravine. You misled us, you say, backing the man into the other ravens. He whimpers an apology before fists, clubs, and finally swords take his life. So we lost 6 clansmen, 2 fighters. You stop, turn your head, and open your jaw slightly to increase your hearing. What's that sound? You ask Fulka. She only shrugs. It's quiet, you say. But like a beat or something. She listens for a moment and shrugs again. Maybe you're just not hearing us cooped up in that tunnel anymore, she says, watching the entire caravan move towards the incredible bones ahead. Can you imagine the beast that left these behind? She turns to find you down on your knees, once again grasping at your hand.
Lightning. White Tower. Who am I?
On your damn feet, come on. You blink rapidly, but everything is dark. A purple glow casts its light on the skin of someone next to you. You growl and instantly have claw and fang in your hands. Have you lost your mind? Fulka whispers. Quit acting like a fool and put your axes away. Try to catch your breath as you look around. It's that same depths cursed dream, you say. The one with the tower. Clear this time. But my hands. Zephyr approaches. Is everything okay? You look. Your face snaps towards her. Everything's fine, Valka. She steadies your face. Then Fulka's before saying, we should keep moving. The air feels full of warning. You walk past her without a word.